darling Fubi Nation. How are you? How are we? My name is Fubi Desaluvold. For those of you that are stopping by for the very first time, you're so very welcome indeed, my darlings. Are we living and loving with the leather shorts? Are we living and loving with the little purple tee? I am just enjoying my wardrobe when I tell you. All of this were kind of in the vault. Well, the blouse was. The leather shorts, would you believe it? I added an extra piece of leather strip so that they could kind of be longer, smarter, because I love my shorts, but I wanted to be fabulous, you know, and I just felt that they weren't that stylish, that short for me, because I'm a tall woman, I've got long legs, and I just wanted it to be copacetic. So I got my alterations lady, Leah. Hi, Leah. I keep her busy every single week, and she was the one who was able to alternate them for me, and I live and I love. Darlings, we're having a meet and greet. It is countdown as I speak. By the weekend, I'm going to be in New York City. Darlings, if you do not get your tickets and we hit capacity, que sera, sera. As a matter of fact, we have hit capacity for the breakfast with Fumi. Yes, my darling. One more ticket sold and that's it. We're capped. But guess what? Of course, as I always am, we've opened up the brunch for you on the same day. So for those of you who still want to have like a breakfasty, brunchy, not a problem. We have a 2 o'clock slot for you. The restaurant is so kind. Thank you very much indeed. It's going to be fabulous, my darlings. Thank you to my sponsors, to Colored Rain, to Juvia's Place, to Gemma Sweets, to Gerard Cosmetics, to Sané, to Esther's Beauty, to CTC Candles. Hello, my darling. Jennifer is traveling, driving. It's her birthday, as a matter of fact. She's driving from Washington, D.C. and she's bringing her beautiful candles because it is so hot that she's not shipping them. She's going to drive all the way, her birthday, and bring them the day before. Guys, you don't want to miss this. It's going to be fabulous. If you want to have dinner with Fumi, go right ahead, my darlings. If you want to have lunch with Fumi, go right ahead, my darlings. If you want to have brunch with Fumi, go right ahead, my darlings. You have the link here down below. We're going to have our fabulous vendor, who is none other than Healthy Hair Studio. We also have surprise vendors for you. Darlings, it is a no return policy. Yes, my darlings, there's nothing like a refund for the vendors. Have them into consideration. It is going to be flawless. We are going to have Q&A. We're going to have food, the catering. Oh, I spoil you guys. I spoil you guys when I tell you, not only do I not make any money from this, I'm in deficit. On top of that, I say to myself, spoil them. Let them have this one time only with us together. You are going to be in for a treat. And that's it, my darlings. And I leave and I come back home. And it will be what it was. People will say, were you there? Did you go? No, I missed it. And that's all that is going to be, my darlings. We're going to have memories. And I cannot wait to meet all of you all. So, my darlings, as we very well know, Biden has decided to fall back and bring in Kamala Harris. I didn't want to cover this story because I'm not a politician. I don't technically live in America. So let it ride for what it is. But you know, for me, as you know, I'm a God-fearing human being. Time magazine's new cover, amid Joe Biden dropping out of the race and endorsing Kamala Harris. Update: grassroots supporters have raised $46.7 million through Act Blue following Vice President Kamala Harris's campaign launch. This has been the biggest fundraising day of the 2024 cycle. Small dollar donors are fired up and ready to take on this election. I will say this. As you very well know, I'm a God-fearing human being. And sometimes, as we do as humans, we run around with the aspiration and determination to succeed. Yes, is that a fair assessment? And there are some times when you feel a shift. You can't explain it. You don't know why. You don't necessarily even know where it's coming from. But you cannot deny the energy. When Obama ran for office, I felt that as it was leading up to. It wasn't necessarily that he was going to win, of which he did. It was the energy and it was the shift. It's going to be a new day. I am feeling that with Kamala Harris because she's a woman, because she's a black woman. And it's so clear as day to me. A couple of weeks ago, although I never said anything on air, that some way, somehow, something was going to change. I had no idea what it was going to be. And that's what makes all of these stories in history so magnificent, because we had a front row seat and we saw this. Kamala Harris had nothing to do with this presidential campaign, nothing. And here we are. And I think that it's evident to see the power of a woman to campaign for Kamala Harris, to have all of this money out here in these streets in a matter. God, I hate this. I think I'm going to remove it. You know what it is? I've done Face ID with my phone. I put on makeup. Now my phone doesn't recognize me. And I'm forced to put in the PIN number every single time. And it's quite annoying. And so here we are, my darlings. Here we are. I'm neither here nor there. But it is interesting to see. Did somebody say black job? This life, I've lived 55 moons. I've seen it go around. Because of my age, I have the license to say that I've got a little bit of experience. Little bit, not too much. I need to stay humble now. And because you've had some experience, you see how this goes down. And sometimes it's just better to be humble and to be quiet and pray and work hard and leave it in the hands of God or into our higher power for those that don't believe. But there is a higher power. And we on earth, we always think we know the best, that we are in control. We really do. Well, not I, because I know that, Father, I'm in your hands. Trust and believe. And I really began to feel strongly about my Father up above in my 30s. I realized I'm not here on my own. I realized that whatever I get, whatever is given to me, is from up above. You can work, but when it is your time, nothing, nobody can take it away. Here on this green earth, nothing, nobody can take it away. That train will go and nothing will stop it. No matter who you are, no matter how much money you got, and I'm not talking about anybody in particular. I'm just talking from experience because it's happened to me. It's happened to me. It happened to me right here on this YouTube channel. When I saw the numbers go, it was unbelievable. And do you know I couldn't stop it? And do you know if you ask me, Fumi, how? What did you do? I couldn't necessarily tell you. All I know is the Father up above said, Fumi, it's your time. Here you go. You got the job and you're going. That's why I tell him, Father, is this what you want me to do? It's easier to go along with him. You go against the grind, against the wind, you don't get anywhere at all. I am staying very generalizing everything because I'm neither here nor there. I am Miss Neutral in this, but it cannot be denied how all of this is playing out. And so we had The View, and The View had their opinion. Go ahead and listen to what they have to say.
So the president has endorsed Vice President Harris to take over the nomination, and she's already raised about $50 million since yesterday, you know. And I anticipate that every Democrat who was kvetching is going to stand behind her. I am trusting that we're not going to have a problem here because this is what everybody said they wanted to happen. Mm-hmm. Mr. Manchin,
yeah.
Don't even think about
it. Sit down. Take a seat.
Sit down. We don't want you.
No.
We don't want you. We saw what you did.
Yeah.
Go on and stay wherever you are. You are not... look, I should not... I started to speak as if I was a speaking head for the Democrats. I'm a speaking head for Whoopi. Sit down.
Yeah. No, I to your point, Whoopi, I think, you know, at this point, as of Sunday at 10 p.m., the vice president had 531 delegates already endorsing her. She needs 1986 to secure the nomination. So I think the only question is when, not if it's going to happen. Something that was very interesting in terms of the energy that you were mentioning, I was on a call last night with approximately 70,000, ultimately, mm-hmm. black women.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Win with Black Women. And it was just about the agenda,
mm-hmm.
circling the wagons,
yeah.
getting behind the nominee. And Star Jones is actually the fundraising campaign mm-hmm. chair. She asked everybody on the call.
Both of you guys
we were both on the call.
Right.
She said she wanted $1 million in 100 days. We raised $1.5 million in 2 hours.
And so the energy is there.
Please do not underestimate the power of black women in this.
Or just women, period.
Women, period. But black women in particular tend to be the backbone of the Democratic Party.
Yeah, but you know what?
Because 53% of white women did vote for Trump.
Yes.
And so I hope, though, that those women will now look at their reproductive health rights.
Well, that's what I'm talking about.
I hope they start
looking
at their right to
yeah.
vote. I hope they start looking yeah. at this ticket. I think the only question is, who does she choose as a vice president, quite
go ahead,
frankly?
Anne.
She can choose Cha-Cha, and I'm still going to vote for her.
Yeah.
I mean, Kamala Harris, you know. So I was, like I said, I was sad. I've been mad for weeks, but I shook it off. Because we got to shake it off, yeah. ladies and gentlemen, because we've got one job to do. We have got to beat Donald Trump and yeah. elect the first woman president of the United States. Under no circumstance can we allow the historical opportunity to yeah. slip through our fingers again. Today, I'm elated. I'm excited. I'm optimistic. I'm ready to go to work. And for all of those people asking, you know, is this country ready for a woman president? Is this country ready for a black woman president? Well, you better get ready, because Madame yeah. Vice President is coming your way.
She was the right pick, and here's why. She's vetted on a national stage. They have a three-month runway to introduce... Mm-hmm. People know her, but to really introduce mm-hmm. her as the presidential candidate. The cons are known. We know what the playbook from Trump is. She was the border czar, and border security is a major issue. She called for giving money to release protesters in the summer of 2020, so they'll frame her as sort of anti, you know, law enforcement candidate. But she flips the narrative on age. She's now the younger candidate. I have been saying that this election could be determined by first-time voters or second-time voters who have been really kind of not energized in this race. She's going to lean into celebrity endorsements. I would be stunned if you don't see Taylor Swift, Beyonce come out for her.
I think Beyonce already endorsed her.
Oh, did she?
Yes.
Publicly? I didn't see that.
Yeah.
But she is going to have so much momentum and enthusiasm, and I actually think the short runway favors her. But mark my words, and listen, there are genuine vulnerabilities. She's too left for me, and I want to see a moderate vice president. I think that will help with independence and moderate.
I think she's
more
moderate
than
you
president. You mean moderate president.
Well, I'm
she's going to
no,
be
her
the,
vice
she's
her president. Vice president.
Oh, her. Yeah. Ah, gotcha.
Yeah.
Okay.
She's more moderate than you think. You know, one thing that I noticed about Kamala is that she is a former prosecutor. So now you have a former prosecutor versus a convicted felon.
Yeah.
That's something that I like.
But,
I like that.
Mark my words.
She is tough on crime. She's
Trump,
a law enforcer.
Let her finish.
The Trump campaign is going to overplay its hand. They're going to lean too hard into sexist, misogynistic attacks and too hard
on
race.
Yeah.
And it's going to make independent moderates, call them Nikki Haley swing voters, be like, I can't be with this guy. I really think they're going to go way too far with her and alienate a lot of voters.
And that's why I'm encouraging women, regardless of what your mix is, who you are, this is an opportunity to right this ship.
Yeah.
Okay? This is very important. And last thing I'm going to say is, listen, she is ready. I'm sure it's a little freaky, because I don't think that she was anticipating this, but it's not like it's scary to her. She knows what she's
and
doing.
And she's been there. She's been like second chair to him through all of these amazing things in this administration.
And the last thing I'm going to tell you, you were wondering about black jobs. There's one.
The economic status of women, you lift up the economic status of families and all of society benefits. Okay, and then let's talk about women-owned small businesses. Women-owned small businesses range from the child care center to the software company. And what I have seen in my travels is that women-owned small businesses, many of them, like there's these two women who are running a restaurant, one's running a catering business. One's in Colorado, one's in California. And I met with them. They survived during the pandemic. And I said, how did it go in terms of starting out when you had this vision? And both of them said, I heard a word I'd never heard before. I was told I was unbankable. So they went to a bank to start their business, and they were told that they were unbankable, that they basically were not worth the investment. And so what ended up happening is both of them found a way to actually have people who believe in them. And one of the things that we should do more of is invest in community banks called CDFIs, mm-hmm. which are in the community and have the ability, because they're in the community, to see the vision of these incredible entrepreneurs.
And there you have it, my darlings. Kamala Harris is in the running for the President of the United States of America. I wish everybody luck. Donald Trump, too, is running for the second time. I wish everybody the best of luck. May the best person win. That's all I can say. May the best person to rule the United States of America win. Smiling and waving to you from London for a short while. I will see you in the US of A. Do not forget to like, to subscribe. Hit the notification button, my darlings. And I will see you what? I will see you sooner than later. All of my love.
Oh, my God.